Well, I just think we were prepared. You know, one thing my trainer, he told me, he said, what did he say? He just told us to be prepared.
Jameis Winston forgetting something a coach told him? Imagine that. Welcome to That's Good Sports. I am Brandon. Here's a quote I have always lived by, Perna. Wait, what is the quote I live by? What is my life philosophy? I don't know, but we're back, baby. Football is officially back, and so is your Monday episode of the best and worst of everything that happened NFL Sunday. If I can put Jameis Winston's mangled words into a visual representation of how he sounds, it is this.
My trainer, he told me, he said, what did he say?
And yet that brainiac tore apart the Packers defense. The Cardinals obliterated the Titans behind 5 Chandler Jones sacks. We had a controversial ejection in the Browns game. Jamar Chase fixed his hands and so many more best and worst moments to get through. Let's do it. That's good sports. Welcome back, bitches. If you don't want your day to be the worst, don't subscribe to this YouTube channel. Today's episode is sponsored by Manscaped.com/goodsports. Manscaped offers you the best tools and liquid formulations for the big 3 odor zones: body, balls, and butt. These concoctions and advancements in below-the-belt grooming are all included in the Perfect Package 4.0 from Manscaped. In addition to the Crop Preserver Ball Deodorant and Crop Reviver Ball Toner Spray, you get the king of body hair trimmers, the Lawnmower 4.0. The Lawnmower 4.0 is an electric waterproof trimmer with advanced skin-safe technology which reduces nicks and cuts in the nether region, aka your wiener hairs. Plus, it's got a travel lock feature, so your trimmer will never go off in your luggage. So, right now, you can click my link below or go to manscaped.com/goodsports to get 20% off, plus free shipping, plus 2 free gifts, the shed travel bag, and the best anti-chafing boxer briefs I've ever pulled over my tight little buttocks. Manscaped. And now, the best and worst. Worst, Jimmy Garoppolo fumbling the first snap of the season. Naturally, the Lions took that opportunity and turned it into a missed field goal. Their first field goal attempt without long snapper Don Mulback, who Dan Campbell famously cut on his 40th birthday. That's just bad karma. Fortunately for Jimmy, he was able to rebound later in this game, put together 314 passing yards, which I think all went to Debo Samuel, as the 49ers offense just carved through the Lions defense on the way to a 41-33 win. Jared Goff put up some masterful garbage time stats, but the final score was not indicative of the beatdown this game was. Worst, Jeff Okuda got absolutely chewed out on the sideline. And to make things worse, this was before he gave up the long touchdown to Debo Samuel. And then, to make things even more worse, he left the game early with an injury, which ended up, unfortunately, being a ruptured Achilles that's going to end his second season. Worst! Speaking of injuries to cornerbacks, Jason Verrett also left the game in Detroit early. We're all familiar with Verrett's long history with injuries, and that's why it's so heartbreaking to see a really great corner hobble off the field and then learn his season is done, as he also tore his ACL, which is really horrible news for one of the best cornerback stories from a year ago. Better news, best! TJ Watt earned that new contract as the Steelers defense dominated the Bills in Buffalo. Out of respect for the Bills, I will show no more misery for them from this game. And there was plenty of misery to go around. Talked about the Bills at great length in Tom and I's live stream this morning, the GPS show. Best! Wide receiver Devontae Smith catches a touchdown on the first drive of his career. Not just his first drive, this was the first ever reception of his career. Here's some other notable firsts from Sunday. We had Trey Lance's first touchdown pass, Justin Fields' first touchdown run, Trevor Lawrence's first 3 interceptions. Mac Jones' first pass goes backwards, and Jaylen Waddle scoring his first ever receiving touchdown for the Dolphins. And Kyle Pitts' first realization that life could be very difficult in Atlanta. Julio Jones got the good Matty Ice. Pitts is just getting the bad Matty Ice, who may literally be frozen. Jamar Chase held onto the ball and scored a 50-yard touchdown against the Vikings. That's a first. Now, Joe Burrow made a case for comeback player of the year with 261 passing yards and 2 touchdowns.
Thank you.
I thought he was dropping everything.
Well, Joe, to be fair, he was. But I love this from the young QB. Okay, we may have overreacted to Jamar Chase's preseason from hell. He ended up with 5 catches for 101 yards. The Bengals also shredded the Vikings in the run game. A 127 from Joe Mixon. The Bengals as a whole looked good against the Vikings team. I don't actually see winning a lot of games this season. The Bengals beat them with the buzzer-beating overtime kick from rookie Evan McPherson. If you compare this to how the Bengals started last season, you've got a lot to feel good about, Cincinnati.
Well, except for the fact that the NFL didn't even think enough of you to show your game-winning field goal in overtime. This is how they end the Bengals highlight clips. The disrespect, Cincinnati.
Worst! Ryan Fitzpatrick had to leave the Washington Chargers game with a hip injury and is going to miss some extended time. Fortunately for Washington, Taylor Heinicke came in and picked up right where he left off in the playoffs, hitting an unbelievable deep pass to Terry McLaurin before finding Logan Thomas with a dart in the end zone. This catch by McLaurin is insanity. I think it is the best catch of the weekend. Worst has to be the strangest fumble touchback that I've ever seen. I didn't know that it was possible to fumble the ball forward this far, but somehow Justin Herbert pulled it off. Ultimately, the Chargers hung tough and escaped with a hard-fought win in Washington.
Best? Rashawn Slater dominating in his NFL debut. Gave up 0 pressure, 0 sacks, 0. He did everything right, and he was going against Chase freaking Young. Early consensus is the Chargers nailed that pick.
Worst? I can't think of a more fitting metaphor for the Washington football team than raw sewage spewing all over their fans. I'm assuming this pipe came directly from Dan Snyder's suite. Nice to know that the rest of the stadium is as bad as the turd that is FedEx Field. And the team managed to pull off a very fitting loss. Best, Chandler Jones wreaking havoc against the Titans. Jones had 3 sacks before the end of the first quarter, finishing the game with 5. He beat Taylor Lewan so bad that Taylor Lewan thanked him on Twitter. To make things worse for Tennessee, Derrick Henry wasn't wreaking havoc against anybody. It was tough sledding for Henry in the playoffs, and it looks like it carried over to the regular season. Best! I'm not sure if the Cardinals' offense looks unstoppable or the Titans' defense somehow got even worse. DeAndre Hopkins caught 2 of Kyler's 4 touchdown passes, and Christian Kirk hauled in the others. The Cards looked like a legit playoff team yesterday. The only problem, so does everyone else in the NFC West. Worst, someone kill Elon Musk now, because when AI kills humanity, this is what it will look like. Yesterday, there was a cat falling onto the crowd in Miami, and now there's a giant fucking panther tearing apart the field in Carolina. I'm still shocked they played the game after this tragedy. Best, your number one job as a Panthers quarterback is to hand off the ball to Christian McCaffrey. And Sam Darnold couldn't even do that correctly. Quite the missed opportunity, Sam. But guess what? Darnold did come back and hit Robbie Anderson for a long double revenge touchdown before half, while Zach Wilson and the Jets' offense remained scoreless. Darnold also ran for a touchdown, taking his revenge against the team that dealt him away in the offseason.
Worst? All of the Jets are already grounded with bad injuries. Oh, poor Jets.
Best, Tyler Pop drop and lock it makes an incredible adjustment on this deep ball from Russell Wilson. That's the type of tough catch great receivers make. Lock looked like Willie Mays tracking the ball down in center field. Then in the second quarter, Wilson hit Lockett deep for another massive touchdown. This one was a little easier for Lockett to track down. Lockett and Metcalf are once again making Russell Wilson look like the early season MVP favorite. If only they gave out the awards that early. Did Russell Wilson even get a vote last year? Worst, Carson Wentz got sandwiched by a pair of Seahawks. Wentz's numbers didn't look bad in the loss to Seattle, but he missed some big opportunities. Now, the Colts haven't gotten off to good week one starts under Frank Reich, but the defense was just as concerning as the offense in this game. Worst, the Atlanta Falcons, just the team. The best way to not blow a lead is to never have a lead. The Falcons were thoroughly defeated by the Eagles at home, looking truly ghastly on offense in the process. Dominated by the Eagles defense, Kyle Pitts, who everyone including me was ready to fit for a gold jacket, had just 4 catches for 31 yards in his debut. Arthur Smith was bad. They looked like they missed Julio Jones, and at the same time, the Titans looked like they missed Arthur Smith, and Julio Jones looked bad for them. Quite the conundrum for these two teams. Best, Jalen Hurts, shutting critics' dumb mouths up. He played a hell of a football game. And the Eagles ran the ball effectively, threw the ball effectively, and dominated on defense. Best, Brown safety Ronnie Harrison was ejected for shoving one of the Chiefs' coaches on the sideline. You definitely don't want to be down defensive backs against the Chiefs. Worst, if you look at this alternative angle, Harrison was the one who actually got pushed first. Now, I haven't seen this since that Bengals-Steelers playoff game, but I don't know why we can't hold coaches to the same standard as players. Why the fuck wasn't this coach ejected? Like I said, though, the Browns probably could have used the depth at safety because after falling behind, Patrick Mahomes started doing Patrick Mahomes stuff, including a couple Kelce touchdowns and this 75-yard bomb to Tyreek Hill. It's like they were making up for all the touchdowns they didn't score in the Super Bowl. Worst, seeing both the Browns and the Bills lose, probably because of special team gaffes. The Bills gave up a touchdown to the Steelers and the Scottish hammer for the Browns in a clutch fourth quarter situation. Fumbles the snap, gives the Chiefs easy field position to take the lead. Worst, the Packers were down so bad against the Saints that they actually turned to Jordan Love, who completed his first pass to A. Rodgers. Yeah, okay, it's not Aaron. We get the joke. It was their rookie, Amari Rodgers. The other Rodgers was just 15 to 28 with 2 interceptions. Best, the Patriots lose to the Dolphins. Just always nice to see the Pats lose. Still feels good. Worst, the emphasis all preseason was on taunting rules, but it turns out the most bullshit call of the week is still just roughing the passer, like it's always been. Za'Darius Smith here didn't lower his head, didn't launch, he just tackled Jameis Winston. And I can't believe this is the only reason the Packers lost this game.
More importantly, it saved Jameis Winston from having that big interception on the stat line.
Best, Matthew Stafford is finally free. And this is what it looks like. On the first drive of his Rams career, Stafford throws a freaking bomb to Van Jefferson, the fastest van in America, who gets up without being touched. Keep in mind, this was a couple plays after Andy Dalton started his Bears career with the end zone interception. Stafford had an excellent debut, throwing for 321 yards and 3 touchdowns in the win for the Rams. On the other side, Matt Nagy continues to waste everyone's time by not playing Justin Fields. Bears fans have waited 30 years for a QB, so fuck you, Matt Nagy, for making them wait even longer. Best, Tyrod Taylor looking like the best thing to happen to the city of Houston since they drafted J.J. Watt. He has the Texans in sole possession of first place in the AFC South. What? Now we will wrap up this show and every week's Monday's Best and Worst by honoring our Bench Warmer Brew Player of the Week. Sponsored by my coffee company, Bench Warmer Brew, benchwarmerbrew.com. Check it out if you want really delicious coffee. I'm not gonna lie, I've got the best fucking beans. So please buy them so I don't go out of fucking business. And this week's Bench Warmer Brew player is Jameis Winston, coming off a entire season of riding the bench. This man sat through a year's worth of jokes, memes.
One of the best back condoms, tandems.
After that 2019 season where he threw 30 picks, he sat on the bench and waited for Drew Brees to retire because his hair was falling out. And then Winston made his move in Jacksonville, Florida, his home state, against a team that made the NFC title game last year. Winston balled out in the muggy Jacksonville heat, finally seeing clearly due to LASIK surgery. He didn't rack up a bunch of yards, but he was deadly efficient, throwing 5 touchdown passes. The first 4 came in the red zone, then Winston launched this cannonball to Deontay Harris to cap off what was just about a perfect day. Winston threw a touchdown every 4 pass attempts, and more importantly, didn't fumble and did not throw a single interception. We wrote off Sean Payton as a head coach, attributed all of their success to Drew Brees and Michael Thomas, and we are currently being proven wrong. Michael Thomas didn't play. Jameis Winston earns the very first Bench Warmer Award of the 2021 season.
You know, one thing my trainer, he told me, he said, what did he say? He just told us to be prepared. Condoms.
Thanks for watching the best and worst of NFL Sunday. I will have the Broncos Giants recap up late this evening, so don't forget to come back and watch that.